பெரியவா சரணம் Glimpses from Sri Mahaperiyava's Life History, Volume 4, Chapter 11, Continued. Mahaperiyava in Tirupati. After visiting Kalahasti, Mahaperiyava moved to the well-known pilgrim city of Tirupati, now in Andhra Pradesh. He was received by the officials of Tirupati Devasthanam with full honors. In Tirupati, Mahaperiyava worshipped Sri Govindaraja Swami and held discourses every night in Telugu language. Mahaperiyava also visited Tirumala and had darshan of Sri Venkateshwara Perumal in Tirumala. During the stay in Tirumala, Mahaperiyava took the opportunity of bathing in the waterfalls at Papanasam and Akash Ganga. Mother's demise. While Mahaperiyava was camping at Nagari, a town in Chittur district, the mutt's manager received a telegram. The message conveyed in the telegram was that Mahaperiyava's mother passed away on Ekadashi day, June 14, 1932, in Kumbakonam. When this sad news was received, Mahaperiyava was engaged in Vedantic discussions with a group of pundits, scholars. Holding the telegram in his hands, the manager of the mutt walked towards Mahaperiyava's seat. Looking at the manager, Mahaperiyava asked him, "Is this telegram from Kumbakonam?" When the manager replied, "Yes," Mahaperiyava instructed him to go back and remained silent. The pundits around could not understand why Mahaperiyava suddenly became quiet. After observing silence for some time, Mahaperiyava looked at the pundits and asked, "What should a sannyasi do when he hears about the death of his mother?" The learned pundits could somewhat guess the contents of the telegram, but could not give a reply to Mahaperiyava's question. At this juncture, Mahaperiyava left the place and started walking towards a waterfall located about 2 miles away. On learning the sad news, the group of pundits and crowds of other grieving people followed Mahaperiyava, chanting Bhagavan Namas, divine names. Mahaperiyava bathed in the waterfall and so did many others peacefully. The mutt officials donated silver and gold coins to the Vedic pundits. On the 10th day, thousands of poor people were offered food at the Kumbakonam mutt. Vyasa Puja at Baggai. On the outskirts of Nagari, there is a village called Baggai. The temple in this village is unique in the sense that it has both Lord Shiva in the form of Kashi Vishwanathar and Lord Vishnu in the form of Prayag Madhavar. In the same prakaram, the outer corridor around the sanctum of the temple. This temple is located on the banks of river Kushasthali. There are 5 streams called Pancha Ganga that flow into this river. On July 17, 1932, Mahaperiyava performed Vyasa Puja at this scenic location. Chittur's greatness. Before Mahaperiyava departed from Chittur district, he spoke on the greatness and natural beauty of this district. He pointed out that the district was great because the following key sites are located in this district. 3 major temples of Sri Venkateshwara in Tirupati, Sri Kalahastishwarar in Kalahasti, and Sri Subramanyar in Tiruthani. Many beautiful waterfalls like Sadashiva Kona, Kailasha Kona, and Ammavari Kona, Narayana Vanam, Kashi Vishwanathar Temple, Pancha Ganga, and Prayag Madhava Temple like Badrivana, Kashi Stalam, Kailash Parvatam are located in North India. Sri Venkateshwara Mahaperyava's perspective. Continuing his talk, Mahaperyava presented a unique perspective on the deity of Sri Venkateshwara located in Tirumala. He explained with the following reasons how Lord Venkateshwara may be considered to represent a combination of the deities Subramanya, Shiva, Shakti and Vishnu. Sri Venkateshwara temple was located on top of a hill and the deity is called Balaji. Therefore, Balaji may be considered as Bala Subramanya. The idol has Jata, hair and Naga, snake that are generally associated with Shiva. Every day there is Archana, a form of worship with offerings of flowers and leaves while reciting divine names to Venkateshwara Murthy with Bilva leaves, Bale, a favorite of Shiva. Therefore, the Murthy may be viewed to symbolize Shiva. There is a Sri Chakra found on the Lord's crown and there are images of Simha, lion, on the walls of the outer prakaram of the temple that signify symbols of Shakti. The Shankh, conch, the chakram, wheel and the kridam, crown on Sri Venkateshwara clearly signify Vishnu. He pointed out that the disputes on Shiva Vishnu arose much later and the differences between the two are not explained in the Upanishads. Considering these attributes, Mahaperyava expressed a desire that all devotees should forever worship the great deity Sri Venkateshwara Perumal and receive his blessings. Visit to Chennai. While Mahaperyava was in Bangai, many devotees of Chennai met him and invited him to visit Chennai and stay there for a couple of months. Accepting the invitation, Mahaperyava traveled via Tiruthani to Chennai and arrived in Chennai city on September 28, 1932. Thousands of people had assembled near Mylapore Lust Church Road and Mowbray's Road to receive Mahaperyava. Arrangements had been made for Mahaperyava's stay at the Sanskrit College in Mylapore. Mahaperyava received a grand welcome in Chennai with welcome speeches in three languages, Sanskrit, Telugu and Tamil. On the night of his arrival in Chennai, Mahaperyava spoke on the merits of Shiva Bhakti, devotion to Shiva, in which he highlighted the greatness of Sri Kapalishwarar, the Shiva deity at the Kapali temple in Mylapore, Chennai. Corporations welcome. For the first time in history, the Corporation of Chennai passed an unanimous resolution to accord an official welcome to Mahaperyava in Chennai. Sir A. Ramaswamy Mudaliar, who had proposed this resolution, said that this was indeed the first time that the Corporation of Chennai was extending a formal welcome to a religious leader, as Mahaperyava was not only respected by Hindus but also by members of other religions. To be continued, Periyava Sharanam.